Okay, Michael, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to step through how you find dependency trees, and just stop me if it doesn't make any sense, okay?
Sure.
But hopefully it's fairly straightforward, at least if you understand information theory. And again, I want to stress that although we're gonna spend some time doing this, this is just one example of ways that you could represent a probability distribution. It's just going to turn out that this one's particularly easy and powerful, okay?
Exciting.
Okay, so the first thing we have to remember, Michael, is that we have some true probability distribution, which I'm just going to write as P, that we're trying to do. That's our P sup theta in this case. But the general question of how you represent a dependency tree doesn't depend on theta or anything else. There's just some underlying distribution we care about. Let's call that P, okay? Mm-hmm. And we're going to estimate it with another distribution, which I'm going to represent as P hat because, you know, for approximation, that's going to depend upon that parent function that we defined before. Okay?
All right.
So somehow, you sound skeptical, Michael.
Well, because I saw that you wrote those train tracks.
And you figure they must mean something?
Well, I know they mean something. It's an information theory thing, but I'm not going to remember what it is. You're gonna say something like KL divergence or
That's
something.
That's exactly right. So somehow we want to not just find a P hat sub theta, that is a dependency tree that represents the underlying distribution, but we want to find the best one. And so best one here sort of means closest one or most similar or the one that would generate the points in the best possible way. And it turns out, for those of you who remember information theory, that there's actually a particular measure for that, and it's called the KL divergence. You remember what the KL divergence stands for, Michael?
Kobler-Leibler.
That's right. And it has a particular form, and in this case, let's assume non-continuous variables, it has basically this form. And that's basically a measure of the divergence, that's what the D stands for, the divergence between the underlying distribution P that we care about and some other candidate distribution P hat that we're trying to get as close as possible. So if these are the same distributions, if P hat and P are the same distribution, the Kobler-Leibler divergence is equal to zero. Mm-hmm. And as they differ or as they diverge, this number gets larger and larger. Now, it turns out that these numbers are unitless. They don't obey the triangle inequality. This is not a distance. This is truly a divergence. But if we can get this number to be minimized, then we know that we have found a distribution P hat that is as close as we can get to P. Okay? And we have a whole unit that Pushkar will do to remind everybody about information theory and where this comes from. But basically, this is the right way to define similarity between probability distributions. You just have to kind of take that on faith.
Okay. Well, I'll pause this and go back and listen to Pushkar's lecture, and then I'll be ready for you.
Okay, beautiful. Okay, so what we really want to do is we want to minimize the Kobler-Leibler divergence, minimize the difference between the distribution that we're going to estimate with the dependency tree and the true underlying distribution. And just by doing some algebra, you end up getting down to what looks like a fairly simple function. So, Michael, if you were paying close attention to the algebra, you will realize that, well, P log P, now that you've come back from Pushkar's lecture, is just entropy.
Yep.
So, or it's minus the entropy. And so I can rewrite this as simply minus the entropy of the underlying distribution plus the sum of the conditional entropies for each of the xi's given its parent, which has some, you know, sort of intuitive niceness to it, but whatever. This is what you end up with just by doing the substitution. P log P gives you minus entropy of P minus P log P hat, which gives you the conditional entropy according to the function, the parent function pi. Okay?
Good.
Well, in the end, all we care about is finding the best pi, so this term doesn't matter at all. And so we end up with a kind of cost function that we would like to minimize, which I'm going to call here J. Which depends upon pi, which is just the sum of all the conditional entropies. Basically, the best tree that we can find will be the one that minimizes all of the entropy for each of the features given its parents. Does that make any intuitive sense to you?
Yeah, I think so. Because we want to choose parents that are going to give us a lot of information about the values of the corresponding features.